Thank you, Howard, for the kind welcome, and thank you everyone here for the opportunity to perform. So I want to first thank Mario for making this possible. I met Mario actually during this at the Arts Club of Washington, which is actually where the Mariachis performed after they performed at the Ambassador's Residence in D.C. So this it's a club in D.C. that's renowned for its artistic sort of contributions to the city. I met Mario, I literally was there just to practice, and the president of the club saw me and said, "Meet this guy." And Mario said, "You are having lunch with me." I'm sorry, I got a meeting. He's like, no, it'll be fine, just have lunch. So I was sort of, my forces unknown to me, ushered into a room, and there were eight other people there. We had an incredible connection, collaboration of mutual interests and desires and dreams and aspirations, and a lot of those have come to fruition already. Mario's on the board of a performing arts organization that I founded called the Washington Arts Ensemble, and so he helps a lot with that. And he invited me to come to San Angelo today. So it's my first time in West Texas in my life. And it's a great way to be introduced to wonderful people. And I'm thrilled. So thank you, Mario, for making this possible. So we're gonna start, actually, with a collaboration that I never had, hitherto this weekend, engaged in, or this week, Mariachi and classical music. So Issac, who is a Mariachi trumpet player, who, just to clarify, is in 10th grade and picked up trumpet only 3 years ago. Why did you hear him? It sounds like he's been playing his whole life. He could be a 60-year-old seasoned Mariachi for all we know. It's just incredible. He's able to adjust and tweak his music to match what I'm offering. And so it's wonderful, a testament to the educational system in this town. So we're gonna play a piece by Dmitry Shostakovich, who's a Russian composer who was oppressed by his dictatorship at the time. And he had to find a way to write music that wasn't what they exactly requested, but wouldn't get him killed either. So this is Shostakovich's Waltz from his orchestral suite. And it's originally for orchestra, and so there are arrangements that kind of try to compress all of the piccolos and trumpets and trombones and basses and harp all into one piano. So you kind of do what you can, try to play all that you can. But to have an actual trumpeter of this caliber and this kind of soul just lends this incredible sort of dignity to it. And as I was saying, a picture is worth 1,000 words, and a piece is worth 1,000 pictures. And this is one of Mario's favorite pieces of music, so you can get to know him better by hearing this piece than probably anything else. So anyway, thank you again, and hope you enjoy Shostakovich's Waltz in D minor.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. I think that was incredible. That was really, really beautiful. Thank you so much for being able to do this. So you see that this the style of Isaac's playing had this vibrato to it that's not characteristic of ordinary trumpet players in the classical realm. Lends itself perfectly to this. This collaboration, this connection can be very powerful. So I'm going to present a very abridged classical survey. So we'll start with some Bach, play some Beethoven, and then do Franz Liszt and Chopin. So you can get an idea of what classical music is, and then after that, we'll have an introduction to some more performers. So this first piece is a Bach partita, the prelude of one of his best works. Johann Sebastian Bach is thought of as the grandfather of classical music, and it just has a great opening aspect. So as if the curtains are being opened up, introducing the rest of the concert. Thank you.
Thank you. inspired was Franz Liszt, who also part of the Romantic era, but different than Chopin. He was the first touring piano soloist, and to do so, he created his own music because he thought that the existing music at the time was not difficult enough. This piece is Mephisto Waltz, based on Goethe's Faust. So it talks about, it shows a depiction of Mephistopheles seducing Faust through his, just showing how alluring devilish delights can be. And so you see the opening is the devil tuning his violin. The middle section is an operatic, vocally based, the devil trying to appear sweet and nice, which he tends to do. And in the end, it's just sort of a plea of maybe Faust will make it. No, yes. So it's sort of a whole kind of operatic sort of depiction in a short like that. So Franz Liszt, Mephisto.
Thank you. It's hard to fill this room with words after listening to that incredible performance. And we're privileged, obviously, to have had this kind of talent share his skill with us. I'm sure all of you noticed he did it from his heart, from his head, and from his passion. Never once did he have a piece of music in front of him. So, Dr. Schmitt, thank you so much for honoring us today with that performance. I want to thank Mario Castillo for always remembering where he was born and raised and making sure that we in San Angelo continue to have the opportunity to celebrate the things that he has seen and heard and done in his life. So Mario, thank you very much for that. Most of you might not know that Mario was an educator. He was a teacher. And he's never forgotten the importance of an education, and he's never forgotten the importance of mixing what's in the books, the education, with the arts. And I thank you, Howard Taylor, for making sure that this community has a connection to the arts. I've never seen anyone who spends as much time and effort making sure that it's not just the adults in this community, but the children that are also honored with his programming and what he knows to be a great foundation for their lives going forward. I now have the privilege to introduce and share with you some great mariachi music. So come on up.
Good afternoon. My name is Jose Ramos, and I'm the Mariachi Director for Lincoln Middle School and Lincoln High School. I would first like to thank Shannon for putting us together and inviting us out here today. Of course, I'd like to thank Mr. Mario Castillo for having us out here. When I met Mario back in 2015, I think it was towards the end of Dr. Carol Ann Bonds last year, she was having a vision of starting a group, a Mariachi group on the north side. And, you know, Mario was right there, right when we decided to do that. So we want to thank you, Mario, thank you for everything that you've done for us. And of course, thank you, Dr. Detta, for always having our back. And the principals, Mr. Marius, Mr. Mandat, for always being there for us. We want to thank you guys for that. I do want to introduce a couple of students that I brought today, some special, very special honored guests. We have some promising Mariachi students from sixth grade. They're beginner Mariachi students. So I'm going to call them by name. Can you come over here and tell us what your grade is here? So we're very thank you, Dr. Schmitt, for your time with the students, so we definitely appreciate that. Without further ado, we're going to have Dr. Schmitt join us for this one. This is called Marcha Zacatecas, and we would like to dedicate this song to all the servicemen and women of our country, and we want to thank them for all their service. This is called Marcha Zacatecas. Thank you.
know if that's actually it, I guess it is, but before they leave, I'd like to make an observation. Years ago, in Washington, D.C., at the Phillips Collection, one of the great art museums in America, not a big one, but they have what I think is most famous chamber music program in America. And I sat there and I thought, you know, I was new to San Angelo, and we were in a very modest building over there, and I thought, someday we're going to have something as good as them, no, better. And so the first thing I want to say is, you got to admit, wasn't this program absolutely magical? Christopher, just cannot thank you enough, because you're one of the busiest guys in the musical world, and he does perform regularly at the White House. And I think the White House would be jealous if they saw what happened here today, without a doubt. But anyhow, back to the Phillips Collection, that wonderful place, and it really was. But here we have a room that's even musically more vibrant and beautiful than theirs. You do not sit in very uncomfortable steel chairs. And there, I think they want you to suffer a little bit to, you know, enjoy the music, I'm not sure. But here we have soft chairs, and then not only that, but when you come into our program, we give you a glass of champagne. And then we take a break, and we give you hors d'oeuvres and wine. And then before you leave, we give you some chocolates and coffee to sober you up. So it's going to be unmatched. This young fella here, Alex, is going to help make that program even more brilliant. So please come, and we will continue to bring some of the great musicians of the world. And the two final things I want to say. Mario said this is our swan song. Mario, come on. You know, we're going to keep at it. You know we will. He calls me usually at 3 a.m. I don't know what the deal is, but I know things will progress from there. And then the last thing I want to say is to our dear friends, truly, Channing Medical Center and our good friends at SAISD, this room and the museum is always something available to you. So do take advantage and continue to. Let's do programming together. So thank you all so much for being here. Mario, man, I love you. It's hard for me to say that, but I love you. Thank you. So, give him a big hand. In talking about Franz Liszt piece, I loved that saying, alluring devilish delights. We're going to put that at the entrance to the museum, big sign. So, just now you can go home, okay?